Number 10. Chantal Bayer. In January of 2013, Johannesburg student Chantal Bayer was severely gored by a white rhino. While posing for a photo during a safari tour, 24-year-old Bayer was visiting the South African Nature Reserve with her boyfriend and had gotten out of the vehicle to look at the animals. Their guide, Alex Richter, reportedly told the couple it was safe to stand closer to the rhinos. It's also been reported that Richter had given the beast food as a way of encouraging them to approach the tourists. A photo was taken of the couple standing only a few feet away from two white rhinos, posing with their backs turned to them. Moments after it was taken, one of the massive beasts charged Bayer and gored her from behind. The rhino inflicted severe injuries with its horn, resulted in broken ribs and a collapsed lung. Bayer was rushed to an intensive care unit where, fortunately, doctors managed to stabilize her. It's still unclear what disciplinary actions, if any, were taken against the tour guide. Number 9. Bhupendra and Jagruthi Raval. In 2015, an Indian couple was trampled to death by a wild elephant during a tour of a remote forest in central Kerala. The victims, both in their early 50s, were part of an 8-member group from Gujarat that had traveled to the Gavi region. At some point during a guided trek through the forest, Bhupendra Raval and his wife Jagruthi encountered 3 elephants. The tourists took their cameras out and started photographing the animals. It's believed that one of the giant beasts became enraged by the camera's flash. It charged the couple and their guide. Unfortunately, Bhupendra and Jagruthi couldn't get out of the way in time. They were viciously mauled and trampled to death by the wild elephant. The guide, whose name wasn't released, also sustained injuries in the attack, but they weren't described as life-threatening. Number 8. Curtis Plum. In 2015, a British safari guide in South Africa became the victim of a ferocious leopard attack. While given a tour in Kruger National Park, 38-year-old Curtis Plum had stopped the open-top vehicle so that tourists could look at the big cat. Plum peered out over the side of the vehicle, trying to find the beast, but failed to notice that the leopard was alongside him. The feline reached inside the vehicle and pounced on Plum's arm. It started to savagely bite and claw into the man's limb. Some of the tourists, who were seated behind the guide, tried to help by striking the leopard with their cameras. The occupants of another vehicle tried hitting it with the car door, but the feline maintained its grip. Plum reversed the car and managed to free himself, but the beast attacked again. It jumped on the hood, trying to reach the tourists, but the guide hit the brakes and the feline fell. Once more, it charged the front of the vehicle. Seeing the relentlessness of the leopard and fearing the tourists' safety, the guide chose to run it over. The animal sustained severe injuries and was later put down. Plum was taken to a local hospital, and after undergoing surgery, his condition was pronounced as stable. Number 7. Patrick Forgode. In August of 2015, a couple was attacked by a lion while sleeping in their tent during an African safari. 64-year-old Patrick Forgode and his wife Bridget were several nights into their safari at the Ruaha National Park in Tanzania. The woman awoke to find the lion sniffing at her back. It then clamped its powerful jaws on Patrick's arms and tried to drag him out of the tent. Others intervened and managed to scare off the massive feline. Patrick suffered extensive injuries to his arm, for which he had to undergo multiple surgeries. A large chunk of his triceps had been torn clean off, leaving behind a gaping bite mark. The couple also struggled with mental health problems as a result of their ordeal. In the incident's aftermath, the Forgodes sued the UK-based safari company for not doing enough to ensure they'd be safe from nighttime animal attacks. The company fought the claim for several years, but eventually settled for a payout towards the couple. Number 6. Joe and Jiao. On July the 23rd of 2016, one woman was killed and her daughter was severely injured at Badaling Wildlife World in Beijing, China. The 6,000-acre reserve offered tours, but also allowed visitors to drive themselves. One cardinal rule was that they never got out of the car. Believing they'd driven past the area where the tigers were kept, a young woman left her vehicle and walked over to the driver's side. The woman, identified as Jiao by her first name, was suddenly attacked by a massive Siberian tiger. The beast quickly brought her down and started dragging her away. It was then that the driver and Jiao's mother, Jo, rushed to help her. Local media reported that Jo was gruesomely mauled by the tiger while trying to save her daughter, but Darling staff rapidly intervened and rescued the other family members, but Jo's injuries were fatal. Jiao survived, but has sustained severe lacerations to her neck. An investigation cleared the park of any wrongdoing, but the family subsequently sued the reserve for roughly $170,000, alleging that it was partially responsible. Number 5. Kristen Yaldor. In 2018, a 37-year-old woman was attacked by a hippo while on a canoe safari on the Zambezi River in Zimbabwe. After one of the guides saw hippos on the right side of the river, the guests were instructed to paddle left, away from the dangerous beasts. Florida woman Kristen Yaldor was at the front of a two-person canoe while her husband Ryan was at the back. The couple had started to paddle away when a hippo emerged underneath the canoe and capsized it. Ryan was thrown towards land and quickly swam to shore. When he turned around, he saw that the beast had Kristen's right leg in its enormous mouth. The woman punched the hippo several times in the face, and it released her. Ryan and the head guide pulled her to the riverbank, where first aid was administered. The woman was airlifted to a local clinic and then transferred to Johannesburg, where she had surgeries to mend her broken femur and to remove the dead tissue surrounding her leg wound. Number 4. Swiss tourist. In 2019, at South Africa's Kruger National Park, a Swiss tourist was left battling for his life in the aftermath of a car accident involving a giraffe. The unnamed elderly man and his wife were driving inside a specialized Ford Ranger safari camper. On the same road coming from the other way was a minibus, transferring over a dozen tourists to the Letaba Rest Camp Gaming Lodge. The minibus then collided with a fully grown giraffe, but it's unclear if the vehicle was speeding or not. The animal stood roughly 18 feet tall and weighed around 1,650 pounds. The impact dismantled the front of the minibus and knocked the large animal into the path of the Swiss tourist safari camper. The giraffe was thus fatally struck a second time, landing on the camper's roof and crushing it. The elderly man sustained critical injuries. He was airlifted to a local clinic and then transferred to a hospital in Johannesburg, where he was placed on life support. The tourist's wife, as well as a few passengers from the minibus, also survived minor injuries while the giraffe was killed by the double impact. Number 3. Quinn Swales. In 2015, safari tour guide Quinn Swales was hailed as a hero for defending his group against a lion attack. 40-year-old Swales was leading a walking safari at the Hwange National Park in western Zimbabwe. Tourists were taking photos of a group of 6 lions as they were standing under a tree. Some of the cubs approached them. This, according to a local policewoman, is what caused the group to suddenly be targeted by a large male named Nshaha. The animal, distinguishable by its black mane, had been collared by Oxford University researchers for a study on lion behavior. Nshaha was known as dangerous and unpredictable by park staff. The muscular feline was a prolific hunter, known for even taking down young elephants. Nshaha approached the tourists, but Swales stepped in front of the group, trying to use his extensive experience to prevent an attack. He shouted the animal's name and the feline initially ran away. However, Nshaha then doubled back, pounced on Swales and started clawing and biting him. The attack left him with deep lacerations to his chest and neck, but none of the tourists in his group were harmed due to his heroic intervention. The safari guide was airlifted to a hospital where he later passed away from his wounds. Today's topic was requested by Sergio Meza. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Elephant kills tourist. In 2018, an unnamed German tourist was trampled to death by an elephant at the Manar Pools National Park in northern Zimbabwe. The 49-year-old woman was part of a group of visitors who'd seen a herd upon entering the park. When it comes to the number of elephants across its territory, Zimbabwe is the second most populous country in Africa. The beasts are known to sometimes come into conflict with the local human farmers, meaning they're more likely to exhibit defensive behavior. One source reports that the German tourist had left the vehicle and didn't maintain a safe distance while photographing the animals. One of the beasts broke from the herd and attacked her. The woman was brutally trampled by the elephant and succumbed to her injuries later that day. Number 1. Carol Kirkin. In 2017, Michigan woman Carol Kirkin was killed by a hippo during a family vacation to Tanzania. Kirkin, a philanthropist and beloved member of her community in Rochester Hills, was on an annual safari trip. Shortly before the attack, the 75-year-old had posted photos to her social media of the various animals she'd encountered in the African wilderness. On August 5th, her last Facebook upload read that she'd seen a massive migration. That same day, Kirkham was charged by a hippopotamus. Her family didn't disclose any further details surrounding the attack, but did mention that the woman passed away quickly in her son's arms. Thanks for watching. Would you rather explore the African wilderness without a guide or live for a year in North Korea? Let us know in the comments section below.